I'm Richard Arterberry, director of Ocean Blue Project. How are you today? I'm at the Deschutes River in Bend, Oregon. We have relocated our home office here in Bend for emergency response headquarters in case anything happens in the valley. It also is a good place, high desert, to be for any type of flooding. As sea level is rising 4 inches, we don't know where this is happening. It's quite a few places. We want to be prepared and ready. We're going to be planting trees on the Deschutes River, Sisters, Oregon. And thanks to Patagonia for helping us plant trees on the Willamette River and in Albany, Oregon at Lynn Benton Community College. What a blast that was. We would like to say thank you to everyone that has been volunteering with us. We would like to say thank you for your donations. Thanks for supporting our environmental nonprofit. Our goal now is to place a federal grant, which is called SF-424. We're going to be asking for a corporate office, two satellite offices, one in Houston, Texas, another one in Florida. Our goals for Houston and Florida are to, Houston's for beach cleanups, Florida as well, but we also have the flooding from hurricanes that will happen again next year, and we want to be ready. So we want to be able to help where help is not happening. What I noticed in Houston is there was a lot of volunteers here, a lot over here, but there was zero here. And to find out where to volunteer was quite difficult. Who was needing what? There's no communication between anyone of what's needed, what is not needed. So Ocean Blue wants to focus on that. We want to find the setbacks of these disaster areas. And what I also noticed is a lot of people are a little more progressive than others. They can submit a FEMA grant really fast. FEMA shows up, they're rebuilding their house instantly. There's a lot of people that don't have the resources to fill out that application, so they're kind of left astray. By the time they get the application filled out, the funding's gone. So Ocean Blue, our goal is to come in and help with the setbacks of these national disaster areas. And to save animals. I saw thousands of animals that were from the flooding, they died. And well, what would we do? We have to get those animals out of the water to keep the water clean. So that's one thing that we're gonna be focusing on, removing debris. While I was in Houston, we removed about 9,000 pounds of rubbish from the flood areas. It was very easy to remove, but it was very good that we got it out of the river. Here in Oregon, we've removed about 3,000 pounds off the Oregon coast microplastic during beach cleanups, and it just really makes me happy. We would not have been able to do it without help from you guys, donations from you guys. So with this federal grant, we have been asked, we're gonna be asking Peter DeFazio to partner, to give us a letter of recommendation to tell us what to do, where we're needed, and how we can help the state of Oregon. We'll be working with other mayors and things of other states of Houston, also Florida, to figure out where exactly are we needed and how can we help and benefit the most for these people. How can we help them benefit? So what we're asking for is people to become members of Ocean Blue. It's kind of a for-profit company. You would buy stock to the company grows, it becomes secure. We're looking for about 250 member supporters. A membership is $50, and with the membership, we don't pay employees or anything. We actually plant 4 native trees. We clean beaches with the rest. We give you some to-go ware, silverware, so you can not use plastic forks and you can stay more sustainable. It's our gift to you. We will be adding names of members on a website page soon to show the member support. We will be showing the federal grant. These are our members. This is how we're secure on the member end of the grassroots part of it. And the federal grant will offer us an office, payroll, 2 satellite offices, one in Houston, Texas, and one in Florida. Now, when I mean office, we're not talking about a high-rise building with fancy windows and desks. We're talking about a very small location that we can keep equipment, trailers, first aid equipment, safety equipment, things to save people from flooding, boats, and equipment that we'll be removing debris from waterways in. We also have to have a place to store trees. We have thousands of trees, thanks to Patagonia and Macy's and Cabela's and other corporations that have given us donations to plant trees along rivers. Here in Bend, not to jump the subject, but here in Bend we have invasive things just like everywhere. We have this species of grass, it's called canary reed grass. It's a broad blade grass, pretty thick there, and hardly anything will get rid of it. What happens, it gets so dense, it's so thick, the natives get smothered out by it. You can see this native is just totally taking over the natives here, and it's not good. So our goal is to plant taller trees, a taller canopy to shade the area, to cool the waters. We will be putting a temperature probe in this river so we can know what the water temperature is 24 hours for 7 days a week. And then what we'll do, we'll plant trees. We will notice the water temperatures lower, hopefully 10 degrees, which will only help fish. Anyway, that's what we're doing in Bend. If you're in Bend and you would like to volunteer with Ocean Blue Project and plant trees, we will be planting this fall, next spring, and we'll have a great time. We do river cleanups here as well. Anyway, we're asking for you guys to jump on board and to help us grow as a grassroots entity. Let's reach out to the places that aren't being helped, and let's make sure that we together can make sure everyone has help and no one's left astray when there's flooding and other national disasters that we're seeing nowadays. Well, you can become a member by going to the website. You can click on membership. It's a $50 fee. You can pay $5 a month, however you want to do it. You can also just donate a dollar. If everyone in Oregon donated a dollar, that's $3 million. That's huge. That's a lot of trees. It's amazing. And it's pretty simple to take care of a grassroots company. We don't ask for much. We're not asking for fancy buildings or fancy trucks. We're just asking for native plants to plant in the rivers. That's all we need. That keeps us busy. We don't really have a lot of employees. Most of ours is a volunteer base that loves planting trees. That's education. And anyway, we look forward to hearing from you guys. If you would like to reach out to me personally, Richard at oceanblueproject.org. If you would like to volunteer, you can email volunteer at oceanblueproject.org. If you would like to make a one-time donation or become a member of Ocean Blue, you can go to the website www.oceanblueproject.org, and on the tab bar you can see membership. You click on that, you can either pay $5 a month or you can just pay the one-time annual fee. If you would like to keep it anonymous, that's fine. If not, we would love to put your name as a member supporter of our group. Our goal is 250 members this year. Once we have 250 members, we're able to submit a federal grant that we need to submit for these three areas to help save animals, even people, actually. And anyway, we're glad to be in Bend. It's a nice place. It's very beautiful. Lots of sun here. Anyway, we will be working in Corvallis. We will be working in Albany, and we'll be all over the coast. Next year, we will start a beach cleanup tour. We will start in Alaska, we'll start heading to California, we'll be cleaning beaches all the way down. As soon as hurricane season comes or some major flooding happens, we will be stopping the beach cleanup. We will be heading to the satellite locations to help where we can, and we're going to make huge impact. The last 5 years we have made a huge impact, and we've done it off just a little amount of income, and that's tremendous. That is proven to me. If we write this grant, we're going to make the largest impact I've ever been around, and I'm ready to do it. I'm very serious about this. I believe that together we can make a huge impact. We can make a difference. We can save rivers. We can save cities. And just one step at a time. And when I was in Houston, there was a lot of volunteers helping. It was a ton, but over on this side, there was no one to help them. No one to help them. And how that works is, the people that write the federal grant and submit it to FEMA, FEMA shows up and helps them. The ones that can't fill out the application are left astray and they have no help. By the time those applications get filled out, the funding is then gone. It's Ocean Blue's project's time to get into those neighborhoods and get those applications filled out. Get those things submitted so we can all be free. during flooding and have help. So, look forward to your help. Give us a call. Say hello to us. Become a member. Help us out. If you have any questions, just give us a shout. Give me an email. I'd love to talk to you guys. We're headed up to Three Finger Jack, and we might do another interview up there. Anyway, until then, thanks for your support. Thanks for all your love. Thanks for your shared belief for the environment. We look forward to seeing you soon. Thank you, Patagonia. Thanks for all your help. And we look forward to planting trees in Deschutes. We've loved it. We're glad to be here. Thank you, guys. Talk to you soon. We're going to take a hike and enjoy the rest of the day. Bye-bye. Have a good one.